Good morning. It's kind of sparse in here today. we've had quite a morning, but we are here to worship together, to lift up the name of Jesus, and to celebrate his death and resurrection as we observe the Lord's Supper together. So things will be a little bit different than they normally are as far as the order we're going to do things and things like that. So we're going to begin this morning with announcements and things like that, kind of get those out of the way so that we can just focus our attention on Jesus this morning and on the event that we're going to observe as we take the bread and the cup together this morning. So thank you for joining us. If you're joining us online, we want you to participate as well. In a few minutes, we'll be giving you some instructions. I think that Ryan and Lauren are online, both at home. They're both at home sick this morning. So they should be there. If you're joining us online, they should be there to chat with you or to answer any questions. If you have prayer requests you'd like to share with them, I'm sure they would love to do that. If you're joining us for the first time, welcome. I see all familiar faces here in the building, but if you're joining us online for the first time, we do want to welcome you. We want to ask you to participate with us today. If you can just let us know that you're here by checking on the little connection card icon that you'll see at the top of your page, we would love to get to know you better. Also want to remind you that obviously next week is Easter. That's a big week for us. We want you to invite someone to come and to join you as we gather together at both 6:30 and 9:30. We still need some help for the 6:30 service, so if you could help out with setting up chairs or with the food or with the Easter egg hunt, if you'd let me know, that's great. Also on your chairs, you'll notice some invite cards. Take one of those cards and invite someone to come and to join with you. Also, as we always do, we have a time to offer and to give back to God out of the abundance that he has given to us. And we encourage you to do that. We encourage you to just pray about that and to be obedient to God as he would lead you in that area. So I said, we are going to observe the Lord's Supper together this morning. So I want to give you a few instructions and kind of set the stage for how we're going to do that. We're going to be looking at some videos today that recount the last hours of Jesus' life as he went to the cross and died, pay the penalty for our sins. He's told us that we're to observe that by taking of the Lord's Supper. And as we do that this morning, we want to prepare our hearts. And so in 1 Corinthians chapter 11, we read these words. It says, "For I received from the Lord what I also delivered to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night when he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, 'This is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me.' In the same way also, he took the cup after supper, saying, 'This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me.' For as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. Whoever therefore eats the bread or drinks of the cup of the Lord in an unworthy manner will be guilty concerning the body and blood of the Lord. Let a person examine himself then, and so eat of the bread and drink of the cup. For anyone who eats and drinks without discerning the body eats and drinks judgment on himself." So those are some serious warnings for us as we approach the Lord's Supper together this morning. It means, first of all, that if you're a follower of Jesus, a disciple of Jesus, if you've committed your life to him, then we invite you to participate fully in everything that we're going to do today. And it's our prayer that as you do that, it would remind you of the great sacrifice, the great love that Jesus has for us. If you're joining us and you've never done that, you've never made Jesus the Lord of your life and your Savior, then we encourage you to participate in all that we're going to do, except when it comes time to take the bread and the cup. And then we just ask that you don't do that. As we just read, if we do that in an unworthy manner without recognizing what Jesus has done for us, there's some serious consequences to that. If that's the case for you, though, we do want you to participate in everything else, and it's our prayer that this would speak to your heart this morning. it would speak to you about how much Jesus loves you and that you would commit your life to him. Also, for those of us who do know Jesus as Lord and Savior, it says that we're to examine ourselves before we come to the table. And so we want to take a few moments to do that right now. So if you go ahead and just bow your head and close your eyes, spend a few moments just clearing up anything between you and Jesus right now. If there's any unconfessed sin that you do that, just ask him to help to prepare your heart as we observe the Lord's Supper together this morning. Father, we thank you for this time. We thank you that we can come before you and we can remember the sacrifice that Jesus made on our behalf. I pray right now you just clear our hearts and our minds of anything that would distract us from just focusing on him this morning. Father, help us to remember Jesus in a way that would impact the way that we live our lives on a day-to-day basis, Father. And we ask that in Jesus' name. Amen. If you are joining us online, this would probably be a good time to go ahead and to gather up some kind of bread that you can use a little later on in the service. Also a beverage. If you have grape juice, that would obviously be the best, but you might not have that. So really any kind of beverage would do if you're at home. If you're here with us this morning, a little later on, we'll be taking the bread and the cup from the table in front of us. Would you go ahead and stand with us as we begin by singing Jesus, Messiah?
I've wanted so much to eat this Passover meal with you before I suffer. For I tell you, I will not eat it again until it is given its full meaning in the kingdom of God. Blessed are you, O Lord our God, King of the universe, who brings forth fruit from the vine. Take this and share it among yourselves. For I say to you, I will not drink of the fruit of the vine until the kingdom of God comes. Blessed are you, O Lord our God, King of the universe, who brings forth bread from the earth. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. This cup is the New Testament in my blood, which is shed for you. But listen, the one who is going to betray me is with me at the table. And truly the Son of Man must die as God has determined, but woe to that man by whom he is betrayed.
Is it I? Ask him which one he means. Lord, who is it? I will never leave you.
the council of the elders met to see how they might rid themselves of Jesus. Then Satan entered into Judas Iscariot, who was one of the 12. He plotted with the elders to trap Jesus. Jesus left Jerusalem and went to the Mount of Olives to pray.
Pray that you may not enter into temptation.
Judas Iscariot betrayed Jesus for only 30 pieces of silver. Jesus knew that the hour of his death for the sins of mankind was fast approaching, and he prayed. And an angel from heaven appeared to him to strengthen him. And his sweat was like drops of blood falling to the ground.
Why are you sleeping? Get up and pray that you do not fall into temptation. Is it with a kiss that you betray the Son of Man?
Lord, shall we strike with the sword? Come on, arrest him!
Enough of this! Did you have to come with swords and clubs as though I were an outlaw? I was with you every day in the temple and you did not try to arrest me. But this is your hour to act, when the power of darkness rules.
Arrest him!
Stand with us as we continue to focus on the cross.
Thank you.
This man has done nothing to deserve death. So I will have him whipped and let him go.
You are obliged to release one man to us at this festival.
Release to us? Barabbas.
Yes.
And away with this man.
Yes, give us Barabbas.
Pilate passed the sentence of death on Jesus. He set free Barabbas, the man they wanted, who had been put in prison for riot and murder, and he handed Jesus over to them to be crucified.
Thank you. Support ropes loose!
forgive them, Father. They don't know what they're doing.
He has saved others. Let him save himself.
Yes, save yourself if you're the Messiah. Come down from the cross.
Show us one of your miracles.
At the cross.
This time we invite you to come up and to take of the bread and the cup that are on the table in front of you. If there are some of you who are unable to do that, Derek would be happy to help you out with that, to bring that to you. What I want you to do is come up, take a piece of the bread, take one of the cups of juice, and go ahead and take it back to your seat. And as the music plays quietly, just take a moment to reflect upon what we've seen this morning. Be reminded of what Jesus did for us on the cross and how much that he loved us. Thank you. take this morning are elements that remind us of the body and the blood of Jesus Christ. They remind us, as we saw this morning, of just how much he loves us. So on that night before he went to the cross, Jesus observed the Passover supper with his disciples. As we saw in the movie, he took the bread and he broke it. And he said, "This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Same Passover meal, there were four different cups that were passed during the supper. The third cup is known as the cup of redemption. It was the cup that reminded the people of Israel that God had redeemed them from slavery in Egypt. But Jesus gave it a new meaning on that night, because now this cup represented his blood that would redeem us from sin. So after supper, he took the cup. He said, "This cup represents my blood given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." The movie clips that we saw this morning don't tell the rest of the story, the most important part of the story, right? Jesus didn't stay on the cross. He didn't stay in the grave, but on the third day he arose, and he lives still today. And that's the event that we celebrate next Sunday, as we celebrate the resurrection of Jesus Christ. So even though a lot of what we've been doing this morning seems a little bit somber in some respects, we want to end on a jubilant note, because the fact is, Jesus' death on that cross wouldn't have meant anything without the resurrection. So he lives. He still lives today. And we're going to celebrate that as we close by singing "Forever We Sing Hallelujah." So would you go ahead and stand with us as we sing? Father, we thank you that Jesus is indeed alive. Father, because of that, that we can have a relationship with you, that we can know without a doubt how much you love us and care for us. Father, that we can come before you and lift up our praise and worship you and give you the honor and glory that you are due. And Father, because of that, we can live lives that are honoring to you and pleasing to you because we have Jesus living in us, because you've sent your Holy Spirit to guide us. Father, we are grateful for all of that. We're grateful for the things that we've been able to celebrate this morning because of who Jesus is, because of what he has done for us. And Father, we give you praise and honor and glory and thanks. And we pray this all in Jesus' name, and all God's people said,